गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग थ्रू डायमेंशन ऑफ बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट। इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव सीन मीनिंग, डेफिनेशन एंड फीचर्स एंड इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ द बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट। ओके, देयर आर, दिस इज द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चन, व्हाट आर द डायमेंशन ऑफ द बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट, मीन्स व्हाट are the dimension of the business environment. So there are two dimension. First one is micro and second one is micro environment and macro environment. There are two dimension. Under micro there are two factors. In the last year question, in the board exam, there are two. What are the factors? What is the macro environment, micro environment? It is the last year question. So understand it carefully, my dear students. Micro environment refer to the internal and external factor, means there are two factor, internal and external. Internal and external factors which exercise a direct influence on the working and performance of individual business organization. Getting? Means micro environment. What is the micro environment? You can see micro environment is the content of internal and external factors. Under micro environment there are both factors involved, internal and external. What are the internal and what are the external, we will see in next. But here we have to understand, under micro environment there are both type of factors we conclude. Under micro, getting, means which affect the direct working and performance of the business concern, that is called micro environment. Okay, first of all we will see internal factors and then after external factors. Getting? If we talk about the internal factors of the business, then what we get? Internal factors. What do you mean by internal factor? Internal factor means the reasons, the causes which affect to business organization internally. Getting you all are, that is called internal factor of the business organizations. Under internal, what type of conditions? First, corporate culture. What? First, corporate culture. Corporate culture means what are the culture and traditions of the, what is the working system of the concern? What is the what's a culture, means which type of values, beliefs, thoughts, attitudes having by the concern, and these attitudes helps to get their objective, their goals. Getting older, if you're if your goal is not clear, if your culture is not clear, if your values are not clear, if your beliefs are not clear, if your principle are not clear, then your working system is not good, then you cannot get your goal, you cannot achieve your goal. So these under internal factor, the first, corporate culture. Okay, this is the strong influencer. It's the strong influencer of the concern, and in its influence, the attitude of the concern, it influence the whole working system of the concern. Getting? Second, mission and objective. Mission and objective is very clear. If your objective, your goal is not clear, you cannot do anything. If Dhirubhai Ambani or Mukesh Ambani the ambition of the Reliance Group is what? The multi-sector, do the multi-sector business, and doing the multi-sector business and the best company or biggest group in the all over world or in the India. So what we are seeing in this time, the Reliance Group is the biggest group of the corporate in the sector of companies. They do the multi-sector business in the sector of petroleum, in the sector of energy, in the field of mobile communications, in the field of agriculture mart, in the field of retail mart. You can see Reliance Trend. So these, what, in each and every sector they are doing business. So their mission and objective is clear. What is the mission? What was the mission? The be the biggest group of in the corporate sector. So they are the in real. Third, top management structure. Means top management should be very clear and confident for their objectives. If they are not clear and confident, they cannot get their goals. The board of director, the degree of professionalism of management, a very clarity in policies and procedures, organizational structure of the company. So these are the main internal factors which influence the working and performance of the business environment. Getting you, Waller? So we are studying here internal factors. First one is corporate culture, second one is mission objective, third one is top management structure. Okay, next. Next point is power structure. The internal power relations between the board of director and the chief executive, it is an important factor. Both are of concern. And the extent to which top management enjoy the support of shareholder and employee at different level also as an important bearing on decision making and working of the company. You can understand by this concept by the example of, suppose under the company there are two power structure and one pull this side and one pull this side. So any company can give the 100% work performance? No, definitely no. The power center, power structure should be very clear. On each and every level of authority, they should cooperate to the shareholder, employees of the concern. Power structure. These all are the internal factors. Next is image. Company image and brand equity. Definitely. Company image and brand equity means, you can see, the image and branded equity of the company play a significant role in raising finance, forming alliances, closing dealers, choosing dealers and suppliers, launching new product, entering foreign markets. Getting you, Olar? So it is the internal factor. If the image or brand of the company is clear in the market, is high in the market, then everyone will ask to the company. If that is not good, then no one will ask. Next, human and other resources. Definitely the competent human resources should be for company. If the motivation and moral level of the company should be very high for the company. Getting? Next, external factor. External factor means which affect externally to the business, to the working performance of the business, to the working of the business, that is called external factors. First one is customer. As we are knowing, customer is the god of the business. Customer is god for the business. So if the customer has made some perceptions regarding any business, then that business cannot be success. So the business should work on the satisfied of the customer, their needs of the customer, okay, the services for the customer, whatever they are providing. A firm must have different type of customers, like individual, households, government departments, commercial establishment, etc. There are different type of customers a business can hold. May include students, teacher, educational institutions, business. So according to that collections of the customers, they have to provide their product. Okay, next, competitors. Competitors means if there are close competition in the market. If there are close competition in the market, then a business will always what? Get the competition in the market. In electronic company, we can see, in mobile company, we can see there are close competitions and they affect the working system of the organizations, competitors. In the present scenario, there are mobile companies, MI, Samsung, Sony, LG. So these type of competitors, they are fighting with each other, they are competing with each other. And competitor, they will affect the business. This is the external factors. Suppliers, definitely, if the supplier will not supply them goods, then at suitable cost or at competent price, then that will not get success. Market intermediaries, middlemen, like agent, wholesaler, they act as a middleman of the in the external side. Financiers means who give the credit to the business concern and help to provide financial assistance, financial capacity, policies and attitudes of the financiers should be in the favor of business. Publics. Yes, external factor, definitely public also help to contribute to improve your branding, to improve your invoicing, and its ability to achievement objective, interest, potential to develop potential customer. All these things, they are the external factors which affect the business working performance, which influence the working of the business concern. Okay. Second environment. What macro environment? When we talk about the macro environment, there are five main environment which affect the business concern. Getting? You can learn easily, very, very easily. ESTPL. Okay, ESTPL. E means economic environment. We will see what is economic environment. S, social environment. T, technological environment. P, political environment. And L, legal environment. These all are the part of the macro environment which affect the business very easily. okay, ESTPL. Okay, ESTPL. First we'll see economic environment. Okay, see here. Economic environment. Under economic, what type of things we see? Under economic environment, we will see the nature and economic system of the country. Means the economic system of the country. We will see in the next class. Okay, it's a very big topic and video is going to be very long. So for today, thank you very much.